Hello everybody, thank you for tuning in today. This is El Shadow Warrior playing 0AD. And today what I'm going to be doing is basically I have a little tutorial. Not really a tutorial, but mostly like an insight of what RTS games are, what are strategy games. Basically, strategy games are about building your civilization and or building your village and building your army to be able to defend and attack your opponent, which they are going to be doing the same, of course, obviously. Well, obviously to me, but not to you. I don't know why I'm saying it. So right now, basically, I'm going to be talking about how what real-time strategy is. So what real-time strategy is basically building, gathering resources, building your town, and building your army in real time, hence real-time strategy, because all that requires to be done in a timely manner, because you're choosing what to do and you're choosing how to build. You're choosing when to do a certain thing, and there's a whole strategy behind it. So I might sound redundant, but for you that is new to this type of genre, and you probably saw someone else play it and were like, what is it about? Like, you don't understand, but they're just playing it and they're just doing it. I'm more like, let me show you what it's all about. I've been playing real-time strategy since in the early 2000s when I came across Age of Empires 2. Then I bought Age of Empires. Then I saw Age of Empires 3. Then I played a little bit of Age of Mythology. I played other strategy games like, you know, Warhammer 40,000, Dawn of War 2. I played Civilization, so I played Ashes of Singularity, one of the newest ones I've played recently, and then this one, which is a free platform game, which is amazing for what it is, free. Definitely support the developers, because this is, as they said, it's just like Age of Empires 2, but I'll say, like, it's Age of Empires 2 if it were made now in the 2015 to 2017, if it were made now. So enough of the chit chatter, let's go with the gameplay. So right now, on my screen, so as you can see right now on my screen, I have it on a tutorial, and I have the map on Belgian Bog 2. I feel like it's a nice balance of resources. A lot of trees, definitely. Personally, if you'll see my gameplay, the future videos that I'm gonna be putting out there, I'm not really big on water. That is due because back when I started playing Age of Empires 2 and Age of Empires 3, my computer, well, back then I played on the laptop, it couldn't handle the water battles, the sea battles with huge ships. It just really lagged out. And ever since then, I just haven't played with any water maps. And that's due after to personal preference. But at first, I couldn't, for the first like 2-3 years, I didn't play any water maps or any like sea maps because my computer didn't handle. So if in the future you see, hey, why don't you do sea battles, that's like another aspect of the strategy game, as you'll learn. That's just a personal preference to me. Sea battles, there's a huge history behind it, of course, but that's just not me. My gameplay is solely battles, on land battles, basically. So we're going to be able to teach you basically the basics of what real-time strategy is. I don't know if there's out there, but I'm doing, this is my channel, so I'm going to do whatever I want to do, you know. So right now, so we're going to do two, and I'm also going to reveal map so we could see what the other, not really the other team. We would have done that for the next one, but just reveal map just to see the whole map. And we can also see where the opponent would be also. So let's go. And then see, now I built my own computer, so this thing would load way faster. So as you see now, you start out with most of the time, depending on the gameplay, but right now, mostly every time you get into a game, you will start out with this, which is your town center, or as a 0 AD will call it, a civic center. You'll get some villagers from the start. And for 0 AD, this map definitely gives you some resources. Not all maps do, but some do, some don't. You'll get 2 foot companions or pikemen. You'll get a scout, which is here. It's called I suck at English. Cavalry, a scout. I'll call it scout. And then you have your two other basically your scrimmagers. So these guys, definitely what I love is that you can have them gather resources. So for this, on top here you see stone, wood, food, metal, and then this is your population. These other things are like the speed that you want to play. Diplomacy is like, if you, for this, in Age of Empires, you will see the scores, but here it tells you what they are. They're your enemy. You could be neutral with them, or you could be an alliance with them. And if you're an alliance, you could give tribute. Here are the teams. There's no teams, obviously. And as you can see, this is the whole map, really water-based. And then this is the enemy team. They also start with the same amount of people, villagers, scrimmage, and then resources over here. So so for this, we are gonna gather resources. What it all depends is what your gameplay and strategy is. For me, my strategy is get as many food. So you'll see bushes, you'll see deer, in other maps. There definitely is other types of animals like tigers, elephants. And in, if you like to play on water maps, there definitely are fishes that you can obviously fish. So as a tutorial, I'll teach you what I like to do. So in the beginning, I'll get the resources, all the stone, and then they'll automatically gather the other resources. I'll put my girls or my villagers, my female villagers, to work. And I usually like to do single queues. I mean, you could do multiple queues and even go up till more, depending on your food. So each person requires, as you can see, above the word health, it says 50. So it requires 50 food. And next to it is the amount of population it has, and then the next to it is the time it takes for them to be made. And then you can also see the other stats that they have, the speed, the way they walk, the way they run, and then the armor, because they also can attack. So I would put them to make food. And so because they're making food, They're gathering here. They're not making it, but they're gathering here, and you see them. They go, and they put it back to the Civic Center. And that's basically the concept of it. You gather food. Over here, you gather minerals. So I'll make them gather minerals. So they're gonna... For the mineral here, it's metal. So they're gonna be gathering metal. And then, you see over here. So this is another thing. You have to be mindful of your population. So up here, it's gonna be glowing, as you can see.
Yeah, see?
So what we do is build the house. And it might seem huge because this is, and I love about what I love about 080 is that you could just easily switch it. These guys are definitely modders these guys are definitely modded of Age of Empires, because I remember that for Age of Empires 3.
Yeah,
so let's get these guys gather food from the deer. As you can see, for me, there you go. This guy didn't want to gather, I don't know why. So as you can see, you can definitely use everything that is here, everything that you see, all the trees, all the minerals, all the stone, you are able to gather those. And one of the biggest, for me, I'll say definitely get rid of the trees that are nearby, because if you can't get rid of the trees, you can't build on it. So that's another tip that I would like to get. So as you can see, I'm getting my food up, I'm getting my wood up. Oh, well, not right now. I could get these two wood. I'll make them gather wood, and then they're gathering the metal. And as you can see, because I did 20 queued for the villager, I can't get it because I'm missing 10, because I have 20 in the queue. And this is insufficient of 10, so I have to build another house to be able to compensate for those 10. But like I said, see, that's why I don't like to even do a huge queue. I could do 5 when I already have established a lot, but that just takes time. So I rather start getting my villagers out as soon as I can, start gathering as soon as I can, because it's a lot faster. So they're gonna mine all the resources. We got them on food. I got them on metal. I have the ones that are coming out here on stone. And I got her building my houses. And I'll probably start making some foot companions, some other villagers. And so these are the skirmishers, or the soldier, the infantry soldier. And then the good thing about these buildings is that when you want them to be gathered somewhere, you could just click on the side and then they will gather to wherever that flag is. So not after, so if you click it once and then you get this person to come out here, after you click it, they won't follow the flag. They'll just go to the initial flag that you set down. And then from there, I could get these guys to start building. For 080, one interesting thing about it is that the women can't build barracks. So what they can do is do storehouses. So storehouses are mainly for I'll say for wood and stone and minerals.
Yeah, no.
So I'll get her to build. And anytime you have them do a task, you can switch them on the fly. After that, the good thing about Zero AD is that whenever they're not doing anything and they're done with their task, they'll come straight to the Civic Center. And after that, you could just put them to work somewhere else. After that, you see you have enough food, you have wood, stone, and all that to be able to age up. So another thing about this is that you can win battles in the first age if you rush, meaning you get all your supplies as fast as possible. You build your barracks, which are where you build your army. So you have different types of army men that you will build in these barracks. So the houses for Zero AD, the houses, you could upgrade them to have 50% health. They have a population bonus, so you can have the houses be worth, instead of 10 population, you have them be worth 20 population, because each house holds 10 villagers, or 10 people. So if you see up here, we're getting close to 40, you have to get another 10 for a house, and that's what they're building up. So that's why you definitely need houses to get your population up. Barracks don't get population at all. They don't supply anything. All they do is you get all these different army men. So here you see you can have different soldiers. Each class has its own. This is a slinger, so throw like a rock or something. These are the archers. You definitely need archers. You have the lancers, and you have your cavalry, knights. You have your shield bearer, and you have your companion cavalry. So these are all different types of units that you have that you can build, and they do require, as you can see, they require food, 50 food, 20 wood, and 30 stone. So because we can't do that is because it says requires town phase. So you can do the basic, like if you're doing a strategy that you want to rush your opponent, you could go with these two infantries, the pikemen and the soldier, or the knight, the pikemen and the knight, and then you just start spamming them, and then you get a nice army building, and then you'll rush the enemy and you'll destroy him. But right now we can't do anything since we're taking it slow. So you see she's done doing her task, and then I usually like to keep building houses, one person houses, keep building them. Also, you can queue up more houses. So let's say she's done with that, you click another one and she's gonna automatically go to the house, click another one automatically after she's done with this, and so on and so forth. So after she's done building this one, she'll go here. I forgot how I did. But that's what she will do. And as you can see, the villagers that have finished cutting the wood that is nearby, they themselves will go out and find more lumber or more trees to be cutting down, and then they'll automatically still go. And as you can see, and then these guys will keep gathering minerals, and this is what I like about the storehouse. instead of them walking all the way here and go back, they just automatically go here. That's what's really great about the storehouses. Also, so we cover the houses, we cover the storehouse, we'll cover the farmstead. So the farmstead basically is the same thing as this, but for food. So if you have, once you are done building the farmstead, you will build a field. And what the field is basically an unlimited supply of food. So as you can see, as you saw in the beginning, we had the berries, and since the berries are what you call, I forgot what the word is, but they expire at a certain amount. These don't expire at all. These are an unlimited supply of food, and then you just keep gathering. So as you can see, he's done. So with the farmstead, for the farmstead, what it does, instead of the villagers going picking up and harvesting the food here and going all the way to the town center, because that's where all the food will be gathered. As you can see here, she's gathering it, wood, and then it'll go to the town center. They'll skip that and automatically go here. So we'll just wait a second for it to him to get full. And I believe that's the health points. Yes. And then this is carrying. So they carry. So they carry 20. So they carry 20 to each person. So as you can see, he only carries 10.
ESD.
That's 3. Oh, I misclicked it. Oh, so they each carry 10. My bad. So they each carry 10, and once they're done carrying the 10, they'll go back here, and then they'll go here. Oh, and she's done, so we could put it over here. So you could really get anybody to gather the food. So this is one of the biggest things that you will build, is the farmstead. I mean, the farm, the field. you'll be building, and if you saw my last previous video, that's what I built the most. It's the field, because it's an unlimited supply. As you can see, it's unlimited supply. That's the word I was looking at. It's perishable. It will run out, or, well, perishable is like it'll spoil, but we'll say it spoils. Whatever. So it's perishable. It will run out. It's not really perishable. It's another word. I forgot. Anyways, it won't stay long. It'll die off. This won't die off. So that's one of the biggest things that I do personally, and a lot of people. That's the main thing you'll gather your food from. After that, we cover the houses, the storehouses, that the coral, or the coral. I suck at English, like I said. This will give you, in Age of Empires, it was what it used to be, was cows. This won't give you cows. After that, so you could queue up. You see my villager over here? She's done building all the houses, and then I'll just keep making her do it. I press shift, and once you press shift, click, and that's how you build more. All right, perfect. And as you saw here, those three villagers were building over here, and automatically went to the nearest, because they're in building mode. So when they're building a house, they're in building mode. So they will go and automatically build anything that is near them. And then that's what I love about this game. Another shameless plug. Another, I didn't even shameless plug. Cossacks 3 is awesome. I like the concept of it, but they need this. Cossacks 3, please put this in there. Automatic. They're automatic. This is why I love it. Zero AD. Keep up the great work, developers. All right. So they keep building it. So coming back to the corral, it's sheep. In the other ones, it was cows. And this one is sheep. So you could get the sheep. They will gather around here. And then you could harvest them. And then this are upgrades. These are upgrades right here. So this upgrade will make the breed time 25% faster, and those sheep will be a source of food to be able to make. So it costs 50 food to make one sheep. And one sheep will give you 100 food. So from there, you can do the math. As you can see, she went all the way over here to get the food instead of over here. So you see how she will gather it right there. So that's what I love about these storehouses and these farmstead. Definitely useful, and definitely use them. Let's see over here. So they'll keep making it, and then after that, these are upgrades. Each town has each building, depending on what it is, will have a requires. Okay. Oh wow, so you can make houses. So see, I'm learning a lot from here as well. I'm learning with you guys. I'm teaching you and learning with you guys. So each building will have its own upgrades. As you can see here, this is the stock breeding. So that means this will be 25% faster that I'm gonna be making them. And I believe after she's done killing, after she's done harvesting all of this sheep, she will keep harvesting all of these. And for the houses, the upgrades are right here. This fertility festival will make it possible so you can make more villagers, which I didn't know, and I'm definitely gonna use that. And I'm probably gonna do some tutorials later on, and some gameplay, so you can start playing. Hey, I'm gonna start doing his strategy, so you could start getting into the game. All right, so we covered the houses, the farm seed, all the basic stuff that you need. This is the dock. As you see, we can build a dock here. You could definitely build a dock here, but I won't. The dock has other improvements, like building ships, building fishing boats, building transportation boats. But this is not an ideal map for ships, because I'm not sure if it's not because it's deep enough, don't quote me on that, but because I don't think there's any fishes out here. You see, there's like no fish. So there's probably just like, you could get a naval base, but I'll probably cover that in another video, just so you guys can know. All right, so I think that's enough for now. so that's basically all the basics of how to build your base. So this is basically the simplest way, just the houses, storehouses, farmstead, fields, corral, and docks. Those are the main ones that I want to cover, but this video is going to be super long. I don't want you to sit here for hours and hours on end. So I'll just make it part two instead of making this video super long. All right, so let's see what we're gonna cover next. Next, we'll cover town phase, which is going to age two. We'll cover more of the, so you see, before I go, like, you can make 13 at a time. That is amazing. I will definitely start using that because I didn't use that before, and I'm gonna be poning. Oh, do people say still poning? I don't know if people still say pony, but I'm gonna be owning. Definitely. And then we're gonna cover more of the different oh shoot, look at that. Yes. You see that? Oh man, this is time saver. Oh, once you guys start getting into the game, you're gonna love it. So we're gonna cover more of the units, the aging, the more of the upgrades for the food, because there's upgrades for everything, basically for units, for making them you know, gather faster, gather more, be able to carry more. There's stuff for the army that you can build, make you powerful, stronger, faster, more agile. Like, there's so much you can do, and that's what I love about Real Time Strategy. So I'm gonna cut this short, and I'll see you in the next video.